Yeah, at that point, that's where he has to start going down, you know, in the classic formula of an anti-hero. So,
yeah. Yeah, hi. A bit more of a lighthearted question.
Sure.
Did you already know how to dance salsa? Or did you have to learn it?
I kind of, I dance salsa, you know, since I was 5 years old with my parents and family parties. But doing that kind of salsa was very tough. Because she's from Broadway, the dancer. She's from In the Heights. So she kicked my butt, and it's definitely something I underestimated when I wrote the film and decided to act in it. It was took a long, that scene, the dancing scene, is like the most expensive in the film. Just the rehearsal time, the color correction, the editing, it was like weeks trying to get it right. Oh, thank you. Well, yeah, we definitely took our time with that. I mean, it took 2 years to edit, so that was like a month by itself. But yeah, I'm sorry. And what was the question again? Sort of rambling. Yeah, no, we had a choreographer, and since then I have much more respect for salsa dancing, and because in New York we dance on two. I don't know if anyone knows the difference. Yeah, and it's tricky trying to transition because I'm more of an on one dancer. And I do it better now, but at the time of the film, I could have been more rehearsed.
Are you having in mind to do like another film?
Yeah,
a lot of films.
Yeah, I have my plan, because these films are pretty cheap to make, and it just now that I did it once, I'm gonna try to do like these kind of type of New York relationship films, and try to do one a year, almost like Woody Allen style, kind of like just showing more of a New York and diverse perspective. And I have one I'm gonna shoot this summer. It's a girl out of college story, a Latina girl graduates and can't find a job, just a very slice of life. And then I got something in Dominican Republic about male prostitution. And so yeah, I have a lot of projects. Those two are coming up this summer. So. I should, right? I met Denis Coté in Guadalajara. Yeah, he was a very interesting guy. He had a lot of ideas. And I saw Vic and Flo, and I was very impressed. So definitely, I think we share some similarities. He likes to do that documentary fiction hybrid. In Montreal? Yeah. Wow, we're gonna come back. Oh, that reminds me. Thank you guys for coming out, because it's looking like I said, because the films were it started very small, and people have been coming out more and more. We're actually starting to get we're gonna get a 1 week run in somewhere in Quebec. I can't really say yet, but we might come back here to Montreal, and it'll be for a week or two, if more people come. So yeah, I have a lot of stuff going on. Yes?
I just wanted to ask, was the same camera used throughout the whole film? Because I noticed some parts were very clear,
yeah,
and others were very grainy.
Yeah.
I was just curious if it was the same camera used throughout.
Yeah, it was two cameras.
And
it was
cameras?
The GH1 and the 7D. That was shot like actually months later, the two scenes. So Juan was like an insert shot. So basically, it was me doing the camera. He gives me the camera. Yeah. So Juan is the device I invented when I was writing the script. All right, it's a mockumentary to justify who has the camera. It can't be me all the time. Although I did do that a lot. So I created Juan more out of necessity. But when he comes out, it's like a shock for a lot of people. I think it's because. You watch the movie through his eyes, and you're always like aware of his presence in a way. And Juan, the real Juan, was actually my girlfriend. She's about the same height as him, and she was my producer on the film. So really, she was the one. So whenever I say Juan, follow me. I'm talking to my girlfriend. An actor only came for that one day, just to shoot. Again, months later, I was like, I need a guy who's camera. He didn't know what he was doing. He's like, okay, bye. He didn't quite get it. I'm like, come on, you'll see the movie, it'll make sense. He's like, whatever, just give me my money. Yeah. Anyone else? Yeah.
I found it very interesting the way you had the British guys talking about what you're doing or all the things that that were commented, you know, like the background. I thought that was very
thank you.
Was it a real
who was a British actor.